In this video, we'll explore the long-run production function. After watching this tutorial, you should better understand the nature of the long-run production function and the key differences between the short-run and long-run. Let's start with the short-run production function and work towards the long-run. This will help us contrast the differences. First, we know that in the short-run, we hold capital fixed. This means all the other factors are variable. When considering the short run, we concern ourselves with marginal returns. Marginal returns tend to initially increase, reach a maximum, and then decrease. This is measured by the return from the increasing variable input, typically labor. Finally, the short run is not specific with regards to a set amount of time. It is not 6 months or 1 year. It is only linked to a time in which the firm has one constant factor. As for the long run, all factors are variable. When considering the long run, we concern ourselves with the returns to scale. These are the benefits of expansion and increasing all inputs in production. This too is not associated with a set amount of time, rather it is determined by the amount of time necessary for all factors of production to vary. After watching this tutorial, you should better understand the nature of the long-run production function. The key concept to take away is that the long-run production function is tied to the concept of returns to scale. We'll explore that concept in our next video. Leave questions or comments below, or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.